So then there's three other areas I've had trouble with. One is there's a light inside the oven that turns on when you open the door, and that's right up here. It's also a 20 watt halogen bipin bulb. That I've had to replace once in about 10 years. That one I probably wouldn't do a LED because this bulb is inside the oven compartment, so it's going to get really hot, and I think an LED wouldn't last very long in there. And that can be accessed through this front panel. Two screws on the top, you pull this front panel off, and you can get to that bulb. It's right in here. The other recurring issue I've had is that there's a temperature cutout, TCO, that's up here. I think they call it the cavity TCO, and what it does is it mounts on the outside of the air outlet, so when the convection oven's running, it blows some of the hot air out the front, and the idea is that TCO is supposed to monitor the temperature there, and if it gets too hot, it cuts off power to the entire unit. There's three or four other TCOs in this unit. There's ones associated with the microwave and various parts of the oven. Those are all automatically resettable. So if they cut out after the power's been off for a few minutes, it'll turn everything back on. But this TCO is a one-time use. If it goes out, it's dead, and it kills the power to everything. The microwave won't work, the clock won't work, nothing works. I'll show you what I've done to that one to repair it. And then the last item that just went out last week, is a convection oven, so it's got a heater in the bottom. There's a ceramic heater in the top. And then there's also a fan to circulate the air inside, but it also has an infrared heating or cooking function. So what it uses is a 500 watt halogen bulb. It sits up in the top here. There's a 500 watt bulb that shines infrared heat down on the food that you're cooking, and so you get a nice browning effect. So you have heat underneath, you have heat on the top, and then you also have the 500 watt halogen infrared, so you get nice browning, plus there's the microwave feature. I find it a very useful appliance. I use it a lot. Unfortunately, this bulb is way back in the unit, so you've got to take the whole oven out to replace it, because you've got to take the top cover off. And so to do that, the way these mount in there is there's a plate that mounts on the wall in back, and it's got clips or a hanger that you hang the back of the oven on, and then there's two screws that go through the bottom of the cabinet that hold the front of the oven up. And when you take it down, one of the things you really need is you need something to hold up the front of the oven while you take the screws out, because that thing's going to drop down like a rock once you unscrew those two screws. You cut a piece of wood that just barely fits under there, kind of wedge it underneath the front there, it'll hold it up, and that's handy for taking the unit out and also putting it back in. So let me get my screws undone, and then when I installed this, it replaced a simple over the stove hood that was in there, so I have it plumbed into the original vent pipe there, and then I added an outlet in the back, and so I have the oven plugged into that outlet. So I'll unplug that, and then I can drop the cord down through the bottom of the cabinet there, because you need to be able to pull the cord out. You have to take the unit from here and set it down on the stove, at least for working on. So I'll put a piece of cardboard or something over there to protect the stove top. So I'll show you what it looks like when I get it out of there.